So each week, Darren Farwell or Leslie McCormick of the Farwell Group join us, and we talk about finance. And in the last couple of weeks, Darren has been doing a series called Women, Widows, and Wealth, and basically taking us through what encourages us to take charge of our wealth and be confident doing it as women. So, good morning, Darren.
Good morning, Marilyn.
What's part three of your Women, Widows, and Wealth?
Well, part three, which we started this back in August, and it's talking about women, widows, and wealth, and the importance of women to becoming, you know, for many women, many already are, but for many women to become more proactive in managing their finances, their wealth, and their investments. And last week we talked about the important stepping stone of developing confidence in investing in long-term planning. And that stepping stone is finding the time today in the short term, not putting it off to later, finding the time today to do things like thinking about and writing down your goals. What's important to you? What do you want your money to do for you? Sounds pretty simple, but actually when we talk to people who come and see us at the office, very few people can actually point to a piece of paper where they've written down, or a spot on their computer where they've indicated clearly what's important to them. And the second thing is to start keeping track of your cash flow. And that's that fancy financial term for keeping track of what money's coming in, your income, versus what money is going out, your expenses, on a regular basis. And we certainly encourage, where it's possible, to do that monthly. Now, Leslie and I help women who have lost their spouse navigate their journey forward using an approach we designed with their needs in mind. And for many, the original thing that we need to start working on is increasing this confidence. And that's accomplished in part by helping to find the time today to learn some of these skills, to get on top of these skills. And the one that I've been talking about is keeping track of income versus spending. Of course, for widows, you know, that's really only when the time is right, when you're emotionally ready, that, and you'll know, or working with a professional, you'll get to the point where you feel you are ready to start tackling that. Of course, that's the time to start. One of the objectives we stress is to make sure that, or to find ways to save time on the kind of routine financial activities that you're doing so that you can actually take that time that you would have spent doing this routine stuff and use that to do your long-term planning. Because juggling many of the short-term activities is what keeps a lot of individuals from finding the time for the longer-term planning. In fact, there was a recent study by UBS that found that for a majority of younger women, ironically, it indicated that many of them feel that taking care of their young family or their job was more urgent than the need for long-term planning and investing. And that's really not a good way to ensure your future and ensure that your future lifestyle is going to be intact. So automation and delegation can help you save time on some of this day-to-day stuff and create the time for you to manage the big picture. And for a couple, spending less time on the short-term activities enables you to take, and all we're suggesting is maybe an hour each quarter with your spouse or your trusted advisor or someone you work with to review your spending patterns, your portfolio, and keep you on track of your financial plan. So here's four short things that you could do to help save time so that, you know, you can focus, take that time you save to focus on the big picture. Number one, use pre-authorized bill payment services. Most bills can be set up for automatic payments for your account. For those monthly bills that cannot be automated online banking, they often offer stuff that can be done over the telephone. Rather than spending time writing checks or otherwise manually paying bills, most monthly expenses can be handled automatically, and others can be taken care of with just a few mouse clicks. So use pre-authorized bill payment services. Number two, sign up for paperless accounts. Beyond saving trees, Electronic statements can be received and filed more quickly than paper. Upon arriving in your inbox, they can be electronically filed in a matter of seconds. So signing up for paperless statements can save some time in the short term, which you can use to do some longer-term planning. Number three, keep track of your expenses using software. Bank, credit card, and investment information can be downloaded directly from your financial institution so that reconciling your checkbook can be done in a few minutes instead of taking hours. So find some software that you can use that will help save time in keeping track of your expenses. And again, using that savings of time in the short term to refocus that energy for some longer term planning. And one that we talk about often, number four, utilize a financial advisor for financial planning and investment management. Rather than spending time researching and monitoring investments or financial planning strategies, work with a knowledgeable advisor who can do the research, create the plan, identify opportunities, and run them by you with a couple of options. And you can sort amongst the options instead of having to do all of the in-depth research. An advisor who provides financial planning services will be able to integrate assets that aren't directly under their care, like your pension or your work RSP, into your plan to give you the full picture. Remember, when it comes time to meet with your advisor, both of you need to be there to participate. So leveraging the resources of your financial institutions, inexpensive software, professional advisors, you can dramatically reduce the amount of time required to properly manage the household finances. That way you and your spouse can be fully informed on your financial situation and participate in those longer term decision making. That's the way to be more sure and confident that you'll be able to maintain your lifestyle and do those things that are most important to you.
So any woman, or I guess any person that wants to take charge of their finances and protect their future, can increase their confidence by following the advice that you've given in the last 3 weeks. That advice is archived on marylins.ca, or I'm sure someone can call you and talk and ask their questions so that you can help them focus on the big picture and ensure that they've made a good plan. So how do we reach you, Darren?
Please feel free to pick up the phone and give us a call at 416-863-7501. We're happy to be there just to someone to talk to and ask questions. And of course, we say over and over, it's important to have a financial advisor to help you with those things that you don't understand and make it easy and convenient for you to do that.
Well, questions can have answers when you ask the right expert. Darren Farwell and the Farwell Group have offered to be there for you so you can protect your future, you can gain confidence and move forward in your life. The phone number, 416-863-7501. That's 416-863-7501. Thank you, Darren. I look forward to hearing more next week.
It's always a pleasure to be here, Marilyn.
And it's my pleasure to learn from you. I am Marilyn Weston, and you're getting it straight from a woman's perspective right here on Zoomer Radio.